Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
All right, on my Facebook feed, happened to see Sheikh Hamdan's birthday. That is Sheikh Mohammed's son. I think that guy is in his 30s or something. 39 or something? Maybe 34 or whatever. Okay. So anyway, happy birthday, young Sheikh Mohammed. Sheikh Hamdan, yeah. Here's the thing. He seems more active on social media like a child, you know. He seems like, you know, the social media influencers, they like to do crazy stuff and they love to have attention. Thankfully, he doesn't show his expensive cars and all that. Anyway, he's a billionaire. But he shows stuff like, you know, taking part in these obstacle race courses and marathon running sessions and skydiving and, you know, standing on top of Burj Khalifa. Now even Will Smith did it. And then, you know, diving. And so he's an adventurous guy, I understand that. But, you know, the problem is he's known more for his social media and adventure antics. He's known more for that. But he's not known at all for his leadership skills. I mean, think about it. Like, for example, if you were to say Sheikh Mohammed, you know for a fact Sheikh Mohammed, he's the man who built Dubai. Okay, good, bad, ugly, whatever, hate the man or love the man. He built Dubai. He's a businessman. He's a brand. Forget all his controversies. Let's focus on what he has done incredibly well. So a guy to be admired in terms of business, leadership, brand transformation. I mean, he built Dubai from being a desert to what it, the global brand it is today. But now if I ask you, what is Sheikh Hamdan's achievement? I for the life of me can't think of anything. Okay, you can say maybe his father is a, you know, control freak and he has not allowed him to do anything. Okay, fine. Let's assume that that is the case. But then, isn't that bad for your reputation? He's not a small child. He's not a baby. I mean, like for example, Mohammed bin Salman, MBS. He took charge from his father. And he started this aggressive, mad, crazy drive. In fact, he has announced this some floating largest island or something for offshore or some nonsense, some business, shipping. Okay, fine. At least they are doing something. Largest green city, largest technology, this thing. And he's really trying hard to transform Saudi from being the Islamic hardliner state where women could not drive and had to take permission from their male guardians to now saying, okay, fine, if you are a tourist, don't need to wear a abaya and hijab and this and that and whatever. Fine, he's doing his part. But what is Sheikh Hamdan known for? Please, you tell me, you know. He's known for his poetry skills. He's known for his horse riding. You know, he has exotic pets. Here's a funny thing. UAE says clamp down on illegal pets like lions, tigers and this and that. And the sheikhs have all the illegal pets on the planet. Then why are you clamping down? You should lead by example, right? You being the sheikh, the ruler of the country, you have pets which are exotic. Then how you can say this is illegal for us? Then make a rule that only the ruler can have illegal pets or exotic pets. Anyone else who has will be jailed. Fine, but you'll not do that because you know a lot of rich Arab sheikhs, they like these exotic pets. They don't want normal pets. They want lions, tigers, cheetahs, and we can see so many videos on YouTube. So, my bone of contention, and don't have a problem with him, let him continue his social media, attention grabbing escapades, good for him. But he's a father to a kid, and he's married, and I mean, he's not a baby anymore. He should be running the country. I mean, like, here's my simple question to you. Tell me, what has he done in terms of leadership? Please explain to me, what has he done independently? Which project has he handled? Which company has he taken over and transformed? The only thing we know is he's a pretty boy on social media. That's his call to fame. And yes, he's the poster child for advertising adventurous stuff that they want to make it viral, like sitting on top of the wheel with a safety harness, being on top of Burj Khalifa, reading poetry, being with lions, doing sport. I don't know how that's going to help a country. So anyway, that was part number one. The second part of what I've written down here. Sheikh Mohammed says the UAE has the biggest safety record for women, or women are safe. And in a way, it's true, but it's not 100%, because I can give you instances. My own mother was robbed at knife point. This was in Sharjah. I know my client was almost going to be kidnapped by a couple of Arab men. I know one other client, his girlfriend got raped, actual raped by a rich Arab guy. Okay, and she has put a court case. I don't know what happened after that. So, it's not 100% true that women are safe. But compared to most of the countries, I would say UAE is pretty darn safe. You can go out in the night, and because it's a small place here, it's a very small place and good. However, the record now is slightly challenging because you have so many different nationalities. You have Africans, you have Pakistanis, you have Indians, you have Filipino. You have so many people coming new. So obviously, crimes are going to pick up. Okay. So I'll give it to Sheikh Mohammed on this one. Yes, UAE is more safe than most of the countries. So Sheikh Mohammed, 1 point. He is doing his best to market UAE as the happening place. Now, in terms of the news that UAE is bounced back and the property market is just soaring up and Emirates Airlines or the airport is full swing, you just take that with a pinch of salt, because UAE has to keep marketing biggest, largest, strongest, greatest, test, everything, the best test. Okay. Last if not the least, the UAE salaries. What? Salaries? Yeah. They were saying that UAE salaries is the highest. In fact, one comedic thing was, there are people getting up to 200,000 dirhams. Look, it's not that there are people. Some of my clients have earned that much more than a month. So I can say for a fact, it is a fact that people get big salaries, but it's not like everyone is getting. And highest salaries in the world, that is bullshit. Utter bullshit. Okay. I am involved in so many resumes, profiles, CVs, personal branding. They're saying India, UAE, Qatar, and that's total nonsense. So now comes the minimum salary. They're going to introduce this. I personally don't see this. Even if it is, if they try to implement, the actual implementation process is not going to be across the board or 100% successful. And I'll tell you why. UAE or any of these Middle East countries, the reason for their spectacular growth, why they have grown so big, so fast, is because they thrive on cheap labor. They pay people the least amount of money, the smallest bit. Okay. That is why, try to get a carpenter from the United States. He'll be charging you maybe 15, 20, 30, whatever, $50 an hour. You can't afford it. the funny thing is what some carpenters or plumbers or welders get in the Western countries per day is what our Asian third world countries charge per month. And that also, these guys are made to work for like 12 hours minimum in inhuman conditions, working in the sun, no holiday, no off. They don't even get a day off. And they're made to live like animals, actual animals. The toilet will be overflowing and they have to cook food. You can see it's horrible. Sonapur, just go to Sonapur and you'll come to know if what I'm saying is true or not. So, UAE is based on construction. So-called multi-million dollar projects. You seriously think if they put a minimum wage and they increase just the salaries of these 2,000, 10,000 workers by 10 times more the salary, not 10 times, sorry, double, triple or four times the salary, you think companies can survive? You think projects will be feasible? You think they can complete all these big dreams? Dubai was built on, you know, there is a saying, Dubai was built on the blood, sweat and tears of exploiting human beings, which is a fact. They get people from Africa, now they get from Africa, they've got people from Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, they pay them, just to give an idea, $200, $200 or even $150 for 1 month of work, sometimes 6 days a week, 8 to 12 hours in the sun, and this is not counting the 1 to 2 hours transportation, and they're kept like cattle. Before, they used to make them stand in, you know, like buses where you have to stand, you know, like they would take them like as if they're taking cattle for slaughter. Now at least they made it mandatory, you need to have a bus where you can at least sit down. So they might bring out this rule, not saying they'll not bring out, but the probability that it's going to be implemented across the board, it will take 10 years, minimum 10 years for them to at least see some amount of implementation. Because who do you think? You think the government is going to start paying big salaries to laborers? You think there are all these construction companies? Dubai is based on selling construction and buildings and apartments. These people they'll not be able to build anything. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share. And last but not the least, like I always say, until the month of November, I'm going to do these vacancies and whatever, after which I'm going to stop. So if you still have resumes and jobs that you're wanting to change or whatever, just send it. It's a free service. Like I told you, I'm not taking any money. But what you send me is what I'll send. Don't ask me to modify. Can you tell me what to change? No, nothing. No shit. Subject line. What do you want? Sales executive. This is what I'm looking for. In the covering letter, in the email, put what is your minimum take it or leave it salary. And fine, I'll forward it if anyone asks. Yeah, it's good for me also. It helps complements my brand of what I'm doing. So that's why I do it for free. Owners pay me money to, you know, donate to my channel and then say, just try to get me some profiles. Let me have a look. Okay. So anyway, that is what I wanted to share. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. It's me signing off. You guys take care.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.